thing would be managing exam pattern. Considering that you have a defined question bank with subject, topic, objective, or subjective questions, now it is the time to define the exam pattern. Click on the Create Exam. Please note, before exam creation, you should have completed question bank related activities and your online question bank should be ready. On Create Exam, you can see the screen. Define name of the exam. I'm entering exam name here. Next is Allow Instant Score View. If you set this field to Yes, the candidate can view the exam score after the completion of the exam. If you set it as No, then the candidate would not be able to see the score after completion of the exam process. Next is Time for each question. There is a facility to define a timer for each question. If you wish to set a timer for each question, then you can enable it, or if you wish to keep the timer for entire examination, then you can disable it. The next is randomize questions. If you wish to have different question papers for each candidate, then you can enable this field. If your exam is for 50 questions and your question bank has 200 questions, then the system would select 50 set of questions based on the exam pattern for each exam. Next is Allow Variable Marking. This option would enable you to set different marking exams. If you want to have an exam with, say, 20 one-mark questions, 20 two-marks questions, 5 three-marks questions, then you can enable it. If you want that each question should have the same marks, then you can set it as No. The next is Allow Candidate to Review Exam. If you set this field to Yes, the candidate can see his or her answers along with the correct answer after the completion of the exam. If you are conducting practice exam, then you can allow candidates to review the exam. But if it is an entrance test or some selection test, then review exam can be disabled. The next is total time. Here, you can define total time allotted for the exam, say 60 minutes. The next is allow question navigation. If you set this field to Yes, the candidate will be able to move questions, that is, he or she can be able to view any question by using Next, Previous, Navigation buttons. If you set this as No, then the question navigation would be disabled and the candidate would need to follow system-defined question sequence. Next is Select Exam Type. Here, you can select exam type as objective, subjective, or combination of objective and subjective questions. The next is marks per question. Assign marks per question. It is applicable when you want each question to have same marks in the exam. The next is negative marking. You can set negative marking for wrong questions. You can enable or disable it as per your requirement. If I enable it, then additional text box is shown to enter total marks to be deducted from each wrong answer. The next is image capture. Enable this if you want to capture images, photographs of the candidate appearing for the exam. You can mention the time interval for capturing photographs, for example, 30 seconds, 60 seconds, etc. This is useful when you want to track the user while appearing for the exam. When the candidate appears for the exam, the system takes a snapshot of the candidate using web camera attached to the system. Now I am moving to next navigation screen. Next is subject and topic selection. Here, you can define one or more subjects and its associated topics as exam syllabus. You can define the number of questions to be included for each subject. System would show the total number of available questions in the system. You need to select number of questions to be included in the examination. Here, I'm selecting three subjects and its relevant questions as part of my exam. The next is question type and difficulty level. Similarly, you need to select appropriate question type and difficulty level for the question bank. I'm selecting difficulty level and question types here. Next is passing marks. You can also enter the passing marks of this exam and click on the Calculate Marks button as shown. The system would show you the total marks of the exam. After this step, you can click on the Generate Exam button. Your exam would be generated after this step. You can see the details of the exam in the Exam Master Grid.